There's nothing to it.
I can't do it.
Yeah, we need one more over there too.
Oh, okay.
Enough to cover the template area.
If we need to bring the other table over, we certainly can. Oh, I may need to make more copies.
And then there's the next turn.
You guys double
that's
off.
Make sure probably
okay, going.
Up at 9. People that know.
Okay, is everybody getting saran wrap?
Not yet.
We did one piece.
Okay, and what everybody, what you're going to do here is you're going to place the saran wrap on top of your template, and then you're going to place your tool on top of that, because you can reuse whatever template, and you can use any template you want. I've seen people do like butterfly masks and all this stuff, and I think that's, it's going to take a lot more patience to do those.
Thank you.
And it'll probably take a little bit more drying time. I don't know, maybe you'd want to coat the saran wrap even in something to get the tool off. This is kind of what you're doing. And the one bad thing about the saran wrap is it does stick a little bit.
Could you laminate your pattern?
Sorry?
Could you laminate your pattern?
You could, absolutely.
Or use wax paper instead?
Yeah, absolutely. Paper. Yeah, basically the saran wrap is just an easy way to not destroy your pattern and for your mask to not stick to it. Because this is puff paint, so it's gonna stick.
Can somebody pass the plastic wrap this way, please?
Oh, sorry. Based off of our little template that we have, and I just did this last night, and it's already dry. And since we're working from these little tubes and not with brushes to get all the details, it looks kind of dirty. It doesn't, you know, it's not perfect, but I wanted to go ahead and do it last night to show you quick and dirty. It can be done. Really simply in an emergency. You need an emergency mask, here you go. And it dries overnight. So if everybody will kind of pick out a paint, I think we've probably only got enough paint for everybody to just grab.
We probably could share.
The white's probably not going to show up very well, but it's worth a shot. Right.
The white won't move very well.
Right.
The color and
the
those other ones.
Barrier. And then the tool
will show up well.
So tape would be good, right? If we could
and
tape
you are literally just tracing your lines.
I bet
that's all there is to
this.
Just on top of your tool. And the pitfalls, and I'll pass this around so you can kind of see my mistakes. The pitfalls I've seen, this is puff paint, and you want to make sure that it stays puffy because that's the whole point. You don't want it to go through the tool, so you don't want to mash down your paint as you're painting. Just very, with a very, very, very light touch, just kind of glide it along your tool.
You guys with the bottles that are shaking, don't shake because that puts air bubbles in your
in the thing, and that's where you get the, it comes out, and you little fart things.
Do you have a finished piece? I'm curious and see where we're going with this.
Yeah.
We repaint.
Wrong paint.
Yeah.
Like, what do we do after this?
If you have to, like, tap it down, it stays mint.
You just pick it up and let it dry, and that's all.
And that's it?
Cut it out? That is literally it. Yeah, you cut it when you're done, when you're completely done, you cut it around the edges, because it's tulle, so it's basically see-through, so it's okay if you have, like, little tiny edges around your face. Nobody's going to see that. So you cut around your eyes, and you cut around this little bit. If you want to cut in between this filigree stuff, you can, but I wouldn't recommend it.
So we're kind of like making a tattoo.
Exactly.
I get it.
If you have done henna and you are good at all of that very intricate detail work,
I get it.
You'll be fantastic at this.
I get it now.
All
right.
And see all these little smears right here? That's what I was talking about. You want to make sure that you have a very light touch when you're drawing this. Otherwise, it'll bleed in on the other side of the tool and make a blob.
And when you're doing it with a paintbrush, you're basically using a fine, like a zero or a one.
Right. And you want to make sure you glob the paint on there.
So you're not really brushing, you're transferring.
Yeah, exactly.
So actually, a very, very small, spatula or...
You could, absolutely. Yeah, anything that you have control over for these really small little spaces. And, I mean, you see all of the details on this that I just skipped.
Yeah.
Because I knew that with these little bottles, there was just no way. I mean, the lady that I saw doing this, she made all of those tiny little details, and she made it work. I'm just...
You know those rolls of tool that you can buy?
I'm not even going to try.
Oh, right. They're probably wide enough.
Somebody's got a
something like
that. Yeah, they're 6 inches
wide. And you can get the 40% off of Hobby Lobby when you're buying it. And two, if you have a cutting mat and a rotary cutter.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So you could, and it would stay flat.
Yeah, absolutely.
We do.
I think we're out of space.
Oh,
that's
she's not doing
that's
it.
We're just watching.
Sheila.
We got a line of
Well, this is
super easy piece of craft. We are literally just painting with puff paint on top of a template.
Okay.
So it's your paper template design of whatever you want to do. And then a saran wrap or,
Wax paper,
or you can laminate your paper, basically just so that you have a barrier so you can laminate it on the paper so that it stick. And then tool, because it's light, it's airy, and it's see-through. And you just paint your design on top. And you want to make sure that it globs, because if you like brush it in to the tool, then you get messes like that.
But
oh, absolutely. Yeah. So, you can't trim the ray. It just has to slip out of there. And then, once you're done, once it dries, you cut out the eyes, and cut out the basic around. If you wanted to cut these out, you could sort of fit. But,
the inside of the area's crown, it's too small.
So,
I could put a rim on it like that.
That you get suffocating.
And it fits your face.
Yeah. I just bought a lace one at World Market.
Yeah.
And it was like,
He needs a...
Do you guys do mascara?
We work at Castle Muskogee.
Oh, yeah.
And they have a big mask ball.
Yeah.
During the recreation coming.
But it goes very long. So if you've got a heavy mask and all the dancing and everything, you're like...
And another secret for masks is you want them to come out to here.
Right.
Because if they're here, you have no peripheral vision.
Right.
And they try to do traditional, so it's like candle lit, lighting.
It's my first attempt at leather.
Nice.
That was fantastic.
Did they do that this year?
No, I did this a long time ago.
They did a class on that last year. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, Peggy does, I think she does one almost every year. And so her instruction is really good.
Yeah.
I have yet to have time to make one, but she gives you, I mean, she gave out this huge handout.
And
she
did
it with heavy gauge, because I mean, you don't need armor, so that was my first step.
Leather masks, yeah.
Oh,
So she gave you lots of tips you could apply to other crafts.
Yeah.
Right, for the shaping of the leather.
Cool. Well, thank you.
When you're all done, I'm just watching when you need that.
At this point, I'm not even on their on the diagram. Because it's like, okay. I just want to make sure I have a little filigrees in there.
Yes. Yeah. When I saw hers, I was like, how in the world did she get those tiny?
There's other tips that you can buy for these.
Yeah.
And they'll get very, very fine, very precise. Okay.
Oh, really?
Things. Yeah.
I did not know
they're
that.
They screw on.
That's good to know.
But you got to be really careful to clean them really well afterwards. Because after the first shot, if you don't, you've lost them.
Yeah. I used to do, back in the late 80s, I used to do puff paint on t-shirts.
Oh, yeah. We're dating ourselves now, aren't we?
And it was, and I used brushes for that sometimes, for like the small details, but yeah, nothing like that.
Do you remember the ones that you put in the oven or something that rose after? There's some recipes on Pinterest. I was wondering if any of those would work for this. Thank you.
Continue. Probably. I imagine they would, because the whole idea is you want something that's three-dimensional. So it stands, it stands out and it just doesn't just bleed through the tool.
Because if you're doing it with kids, it's really, really cheap, and it was all natural stuff, sort of.
Oh, yeah.
So that, if your two-year-old ate it, I wouldn't be freaking out. And he puts everything in his mouth. What does this taste like?
Exactly. I had a horse that was like that. She related to everything as long as it could go in her mouth. She was like, I can put it. Okay, I'm good with that.
That would be fun. Yeah, I saw the paint on Pinterest and thought, okay, that would be something he could work with.
Oh, wow, that's, you're getting detailed. That's
good. That is good. I wish mine was that good.
You know what I was thinking of is the difference in how evil in all his looks as opposed to how feminine and stuff some of the other ones look. His looks very boyish in the red.
Red.
I don't know if you're going for that. Let's touch.
Yeah.
Yeah, if they don't touch, the net will stretch more.
Another secret of puff paint is to start squeezing your bottle before you start moving.
Oh, yeah.
So that you... Now, I've never been able to coordinate it quite as well as like describe it. But.
It's been a long time since I have.
Okay, so were you a sewer in the 80s? Mm-hmm. Did you do like the take the big print appliques off of other material and cut it out, iron it on, and then do the puff paint over the top?
Yeah, I took a pair of blue jeans and cut the bottom, the legs off, and made a skirt out of it with white fabric, and it had puff paint and slick paint and all sorts of stuff on the bottom of that skirt.
I think I saw some of those hanging in my closet. Because you're a Paris to give them goodwill.
That's the pattern. The saran wrap is between the pattern and the tool.
Okay, wrinkles.
And then the wrinkles take more puff and outline the pattern. You can't get real fine details with these colors. It's just paint room. And somebody said there's actually some finer tips that you apply to the puff paint.
They used to sell them with finer tips too.
Close to being done, so you can have the puff paint. As I move closer. And I think tape would help a lot. I don't know, Lou. We hadn't asked that question.
What question?
How long does it take to dry?
She said the one she did last night is dry now. So
you have to carry back so it
connects this to here.
I think
so that when you cut it out.
You know, you've got to have some little bit of structure to hold it together if you don't want it.
Of course.
Like maybe at least connect it in the middle and then like over the eye or something. Because if you try and cut that out, then the top bit won't have enough.
Usually
the body does hold together.
This is a regular measure.
That's the way it's supposed to work. Things never work the way they're supposed to.
No.
So how long does it take to dry typically?
Mine took overnight.
Did it take that long?
Yeah. It'll sort of dry in a couple of hours, but it's puff paint. You can still smoosh it down. But it's really dry now. I ended up kind of separating it from the saran wrap, and I think it was maybe 2-3 hours after I painted it, just to kind of make sure it would separate. Right.
Where do you get your patterns at?
I just got that one online. I Googled filigree, you know, masks or cheap,
I think we found these at the same time.
Yeah, cheap, easy masks. This lady put a tutorial on doing this, and I was like, really? Really? Holy crap! Because for the Costumers Guild, for our Costumers Lost Weekend in June, we're having a masquerade party. And so we were all like, in September, I think it was, when we decided, we're gonna do masquerade party. Everybody was on Pinterest going, masks. And same thing.
It's in June
this
year.
I started
it. I'm sorry.
It's
in June this year.
It's probably be better to start in the middle and work outward. I was thinking on either side.
Keep them sticking your feet in.
I know.
Somebody else had rented the hotel July. We wanted to do it July, so we're like, well, exactly. Let me jump on that weekend. let's go ahead and book it now.
So then use hot glue to put ribbons on it for the tie, or how do you attach the tie?
You can sew them on because it's tulle. If you need to use hot glue, I think that would be fine. It will definitely hold.
So sewing would work.
Okay. Sewing can work. I mean, you know, you'd have to be really careful with it, but really intricate with your stitch. But yeah, you can sew on tulle.
So typically you don't try to get in the middle of the tool and cut all the little details out?
No, you'll want to cut the eyes out for sure, and you want to cut the outline. And like, on mine, I didn't do any of the detail, so if you wanted to go in there and with, you know, a little scalpel,
and some of the
larger spacings, you can. But it's white too. Nobody's gonna see it. Not even. I don't even think in the day anybody's gonna notice it. They're just gonna see all of the intricate lining.
Do you have completely done mask or just what you did last night?
Yeah.
Yeah. These things are not looking the same.
Test yourself out. Don't try to push it in. Don't rub it
in. No, I know. I figured that out.
Not for anybody.
That's cool.
Tool stream.
Plus you can get tool on the scrap bin occasionally. If you only need like one piece,
really?
You can just get remnants. Yeah, they're like $1.
Duh.
They're real cheap. And you can get different colors too.
Well, it's still selling like 77 cents a yard.
I like 70 cents.
Pretty.
It's closer to free.
Yeah.
No, the plastic peels off.
No. This.
Oh yeah. You cut out around the edges and the eyes with it. That's about all you have to cut. In the larger areas you can go and cut them out so that you don't have to.
Same here. The computer stock seems to be working really well for me.
My SCD doesn't do well. This is why I
That's the one you did last night.
Yeah, I did that in like 2 minutes. So, it's not pretty. It's not
but
perfect.
But she kept
it
larger.
Okay, I'm not going to do anymore.
I said, but it,
the halves have to go to the
top. It's quick. It's
dry.
Yeah.
Too much.
Yeah. Everything's connected.
You could.
Oh, you could. They're sequins.
Yeah. You could just stick them right in the paint.
Yeah. Because buff paint is kind of like a glue.
Did you ever just
awesome.
That's what
you
hide from the camera.
Yeah. I think though, we're not iron tool first. Wrinkles are not helping me.
Yeah, and you can buy tool that has a little bit of thicker consistency too. It just there's all sorts of different kind of nets and tools that you can use.
Yeah.
You just kind of experiment.
Scratchy tool.
I keep moving it.
Rebecca doesn't like.
Oh, you're not really wanting to touch the material.
No, I wasn't touching the tape. It's just
now that I think about it, you could probably tape this around like a kitchen
table. Oh yeah.
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 You could put it, or you could put it in an embroidery hoop, or sometimes I've seen embroidery hoops, but they're square. Yeah, frames.
I think with kids in general,
what are you doing?
I would put a bracelet down and make it look like
a square.
Because it's going to be, if you're turning around my face, it's going to be.
Oh, you have one.
Pretty good on
that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I have one.
It'll probably never dry. Maybe before I fly home tomorrow.
India.
I see this as a foundational future work.
I can see this as a breastplate thing too.
Yeah,
but
the team might just have a good picture of it for the best
like,
next time.
To do it for the first time.
Because usually it does happen
when you're sure
here.
Oh,
I like those dots.
Yeah, you can do sparkle.
Yeah, these in the tubes are, they actually call them like jewel dots or something.
I spread
dots. I don't even know if Ben had turned out. You could make some ready for armor for dogs.
Is it going to stay shiny with the
yeah.
Oh, I guess, yeah.
Okay.
Well, even the buff metal stays shiny until you
pop it. Looking at the symmetry. Something that.
Oh, it's on the
it's easy
thing.
To find something. Find something that might work better.
I'm gonna be making myself.
You know,
a
blue tape.
I where my room material
mm-hmm.
I
would
I know where.
Probably wax paper.
Don't make me laugh.
Jesus, she doesn't like
the
life of the
room.
Hey, where's Waldo? Where's Waldo?
Right here.
That way you do it.
He calls it.
Oh. The edge is that it doesn't stick to your paper.
It changes colors when it's dry.
Was he still at his
temperature
tantrum?
Yeah. It changes colors when it's dry.
Yeah,
and it's
got
swirly
things.
Yeah, dark things.
He's just going around. Then
some of these have higher tips than others.
Okay. Bye, Davey.
Hey, Dave. People are going to want to talk to you when you're out there, you know. People are going to want to talk to you.
Oh,
his biggest fear is to talk to somebody he doesn't know.
The baby. The t-shirt.
He's so shy.
So we're going to be taking some pictures of him with Kaylee's Sonic.
Nice.